and today is Thanksgiving Sunday. I am super excited. Are you ready for praise and worship? You don't even have a choice. You have to be ready for praise and worship because we need to praise God. It is amazing to praise the Lord. Can you put on your dancing shoes? Your dancing shoes should be on, okay? I have mine here. Are you ready? Okay, put your hands together and close your eyes. Lord, we thank you and we glorify your name. We thank you because you are amazing. You are a good Father. Lord, even as we praise you, even as we worship you, we ask that you come and dwell in our presence and you help us to praise and worship you as we ought to, in the name of Jesus.
I'm overwhelmed. that's all I need. I humble all I am, all to you. One way, Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for. One way, Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for. You're the only one, you're the only one. You're the only one that I could live for. You're the only one, you're the only one. You're the only one that I could live for. You were always, always there. Everyhow and everywhere. It breaks a bell so deeply within me. You will never, ever change. Yesterday, today,
afraid to shout. So come on and lift your hands.
Concentrate and worship the living God. You can raise your hands up, you can kneel down, whatever you want to do, just ensure that you are worshiping the living God. All right. Good Father, mighty Father, Lord, even as we go to learn at your feet, we ask that you help us listen, help us to understand, help us to learn at your feet, O God, in Jesus' name. We pray, most heavenly Father, that we'll not just hear these words, but help us to do your word in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father, Lord, for in Jesus' amazing name we have prayed. Amen.
Good morning. It's another exciting Sunday to be here. Remember, we are C-Rock, and like we always say, it is time for us to say our good mornings. Are you ready? Awesome. Now turn to your neighbor on the right and say, good morning, good morning. Then you turn to your neighbor on the left and you say, good morning, good morning. What do you do next? You wave your hands and say, good morning to you all. Okay, let's settle down and remember to eliminate all forms of distractions as we dive into God's word. But before we begin, let's go through our five items. Remember, our five items are your Bible, a notebook, a pen or a pencil, your fresh fire devotional, and your offerings. Awesome. I know you have them ready. So last week, can you remind us of what we learned? Last week, we looked at quite an interesting topic, and it was the beginning of the month of August. I know you're home. So we looked at the topic, create in His image. Yes, we said that to create means to merge the practical and the imaginary. Do you remember? Good. And we also said that we are co-creators. Yes, you and I are co-creators. And we need three tools. Can you tell me the first two? You're correct. Number one, we need the Word of God. Yes. And number two, can you tell me? Number two, what's number two? The mind. Great. And we said number three, we need the tongue. But today, we're going to look at another part of create, which is prophecy. Yes. God is giving you the creative idea and He is releasing the creative energy to bind these ideas into life. And so shall it be in Jesus' name. Amen. The first step in creative process is to prophesy. Yes, yes, yes. Prophesy. Have you heard of the word prophesy before? Okay, have you? We're going to look at someone who prophesied. So our lesson today is taking us into a Bible story, a very interesting Bible story in Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 1 to 10. I'd like you to read it because it is quite an interesting story. Just like we see in the picture. Can you see that picture? God took Ezekiel, Ezekiel to a valley filled with dry bones. Can you imagine? You get to a valley, like a place filled with dry bones, everywhere dry bones. I know you'll be wondering. Now, not only were there dry bones, but they were also very dry. And worse, still scattered all over the place. So this is how it is. Imagine bones everywhere. Very dry. Very, very dry. Scattered all around. And you know what? God said to Ezekiel, prophesy. Prophesy on these dry bones. I'm sure Ezekiel will be like, I should prophesy on these dry bones. Will these dry bones become humans or something? But guess what? Ezekiel actually prophesied, and these dry bones from all around, there was like a rushing sound and each part joining together. Wow, isn't that amazing?
After many years of rebellion and idolatry, God allowed His people, the Israelites, to be taken captive by the Empire of Babylon. This was a dark and discouraging time for the Israelites. Their temple, land, and nation had been lost. It was during this time that God gave an incredible vision of hope and new life to a prophet named Ezekiel. In Ezekiel's vision, the Spirit of the Lord carried him to the middle of a valley filled with dry bones that were scattered all over the place. As the Spirit of the Lord led Ezekiel through this valley of bones, God asked him, "Can these bones live again?" Ezekiel responded, "O Sovereign Lord, only You know the answer to that." Then God told Ezekiel to speak a message of prophecy to the dry bones that surrounded him, saying, "Dry bones, listen to the word of the Lord. I will put breath into you and make you live again. I will put flesh and skin on you, and you will return to life. When I breathe new life into you, then you will know that I am the Lord. So Ezekiel spoke just as the Lord commanded. And as Ezekiel said the words of God's prophecy, a great rattling sound filled the valley. The bones of each body came together and connected themselves to form complete skeletons. As Ezekiel watched, muscles and flesh formed over the bones, and then skin formed over the bodies. But there was no breath in them. There was no life in these bodies. Then God commanded Ezekiel to speak a prophecy to the winds by saying, "Come, O breath, from the four winds, breathe into these dead bodies, that they may live again." As Ezekiel spoke these words, breath came into their bodies, and they all came to life. There in this valley, a vast army of living men stood before Ezekiel. Then God explained to Ezekiel that the bones in the valley represented the people of Israel, dried up, out of hope, and out of life. Then God told Ezekiel to prophesy to Israel, "O my people, I will open your graves and cause you to rise. I will bring you out of captivity and back to the land of Israel." God gave Ezekiel this final message to prophesy for his people. "When you return, you will know that I am the Lord. I will put my spirit in you, and you will live again. You will return home to your own land." The Lord told Ezekiel to tell the people of Israel that, when this all comes to pass, they will know that it was the Lord who caused these things to happen, and that the Lord had fulfilled his word.
We're going to look at three things from Ezekiel's experience with God in the valley of the dry bones. Are you ready? Get set. Let's go. The first is to prophesy your destiny. Watch the word you speak. The Bible says that our words are spirit and life. That means we must watch what we say, because it is from the mouth you speak. The truth is that your word shape your life. So as a child, if you are saying, "I have big head, I'm not knowledgeable, I don't know this, I'm not good in this," that means you're prophesying negatively into your mind, and you are feeding yourself with negative utterances. God is saying to you today to watch what you say. As God's children, created in his image, the word that you speak are very powerful. Tell your neighbor that your words are powerful. Mm-hmm. Your words are powerful. So when you speak, you have to speak with what? Caution. You speak only the right things. You speak only positive things. When you speak, child of God, you are actually calling things into existence, creating. So be careful. Little mouth, what you speak. Tell your mouth. Be careful, little mouth, what you speak. Yes. Do not call things as you see it. Mm-hmm. You call it as God sees it. So when you go somewhere and, you know, there's darkness or something, you don't say, "I see darkness." You say, "I see light." And what do? You speak light and you speak life. So as a child of God, you have to what? Control what flows out from your little lips. Yes. Because out of your mouth, you can speak both positive and negative things. But I know you will choose to prophesy positive things into your life and others. So moving forward from today, everything you say from your mouth should be positive. So wherever you find yourself, when things are not working, you say, I prophesy this thing works. Yes. For example, you have a mathematics problem and you don't understand. You don't say, I don't understand. You don't say that. You say, I understand. You say, I know all things because Christ has given you the ability. So, to prophesy your destiny, you have to watch what you say. Yes. Let's go to number two. To prophesy your destiny, the name that you bear is very important. Yes, names are significant and important. Nothing prophesies your future more accurately than your name. It is because every time someone calls your name, they are prophesying. So your name is very, very important. Abram was a good name, but not great enough for what God had in mind. So you know what happened? God changed it from Abram to Abraham, a great name. So what's your name? Ask your parents, what's the meaning of your name? Yes, because the name is actually what prophesying into your future. And I know you have amazing, amazing names, and God will help you get to your destiny. Say amen. Amen. So
this is Abram, who will later be known as Abraham.
Hey.
When Abram was in the land called Canaan, God told him to look over the land as far as his eyes could see. God promised that the land would be blessed and that Abram would have many children.
Ah.
25 years passed. Abram and Sarai were very old and still had no children. God appeared to Abram and said, "Don't be afraid. I'm your shield. A son is coming. Look at the heavens and count the stars. Someday, you will have as many children as there are stars in the sky." Then God told Abram that his name would no longer be Abram, but it would be Abraham, which means father of many nations. God also told Abraham that Sarai's name would be changed to Sarah. God promised to bless Sarah and told Abraham that she would become pregnant and have a son. God made a covenant with Abraham that day. His covenant was a promise that Abraham would have many sons and they would be blessed.
So the first thing we looked at to prophesy, you watch what you say. And number two, we said to prophesy your destiny, your name is important. And we'll go straight to number three. To prophesy your destiny, flow with God, the Creator. You prophesy your destiny by flowing with God, the Creator. Yes, just like Ezekiel did and said, everything God told me to do and speak. So, just like Ezekiel and like Bezalel, we must learn to flow with our Father, the Creator of everything. Yes. So, let's go back to the three things we learned from Ezekiel. And we said that the number one thing is to prophesy your destiny, you have to watch the words that you speak. We also said that number two, to prophesy your destiny, the name that you bear is very important. And we said number three, to prophesy your destiny, flow with God the Creator, just like Ezekiel. Yes, so we see that it is very important, irrespective of how little you are or how old you are, you must watch these things. And I pray that in the name of Jesus, that God will help you. Say amen. Amen. We have a word search, and it's going to be fun. Yes, you can see it on the screen. And if you have the hard copy, you can go through the word search. So have fun searching for the word in the word back and discovering some hidden words too. Yes, that's a very beautiful word search. So take your time and go through everything and get new words. So remember to always read your Bible and pray every day. On Monday, I'd like you to read Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 1 to 10. Remember, read your Bible, pray every day, pray every day, pray every day. Read your Bible, pray every day if you want to grow.
If you want to grow, if you want to grow, read your Bible and pray every day if you want to grow. If you don't read your Bible and forget to pray, forget to pray, forget to pray. If you don't read your Bible and forget to pray, oh, you will not grow.
Subscribe to our channel and download the new Three Little Words gaming app for free in your device. Let's have fun together!
Yes, and in order for you to prophesy positively, it is important you read the scriptures. Very, very important. So on Monday, it is Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 1 to 10. And on Tuesday, you read Matthew chapter 12, verse 37. On Wednesday, you read Amos chapter 3, verse 7 to 8. And on Thursday, you read John chapter 10, verse 34. And on Friday, you also read Luke chapter 21, verse 33. And on Saturday, you read Psalm 107, verse 20. Always, always ensure to read your Bible and pray every day. It's time for us to take our life application. I want you to stand up. Yes, stand up, stand up. Place your right hand on your chest and say, I speak as God speaks. Remember, we are co-creator. And we have the ability to prophesy. So you say it with boldness. I speak as God speaks. I am filled with God's Spirit. I flow with God doing and speaking what He tells me. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'd like us to take a memory verse together. A memory verse is taken from Exodus chapter 31, verse 3. And it says, I have filled Bezalel with the Spirit of God. I have given him the skill, ability, and knowledge to do all kinds of work. Can we say it together? Our memory verse is taken from Exodus chapter 31, verse 3. And it says, I have filled Bezalel with the Spirit of God. I have given him the skill, ability, and knowledge to do all kinds of work. So every day, remember, your memory verse, yes, it's very important. This will help you prophesy into your life and your future and even to others. So let's close our eyes as we take our prayer. Say, Father, help me only say what you say. Please make my name great and teach me how to flow with you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. So I'll see you same time next week on C-Rock. It's bye from me and it's bye from C-Rock. Bye-bye.